Good Saturday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with your updated edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime. This is our offering to you to give you more detailed information about what's going on with the forecast as we go into the rest of the weekend, more than we can usually get in a normal 3-minute weathercast on air. So again, your opportunity to participate tonight, drop your location and your weather reports, if you have any, into the comments section down below, and we'll talk about what's going on around the Mid-South area, temperature, wind speed, cloud cover, anything like that. If you've got weather pictures, send them on to me. You can find me again on the social media websites, and we'll be featuring some of your weather pictures over the last week coming up here in just a little bit, so stay tuned for that right after the forecast. We've got some activity in the tropics that we need to talk about, and some of that's not quite in the tropics, but just off the East Coast of the United States, which could become what's called a nor'easter storm. It's already causing problems for travelers in the Carolinas, but for right now, it doesn't look to be a major problem for us here in the Mid-South area. But we will be seeing changes coming our way. First and foremost, a little bit more mild conditions. Again, temperatures on the 7 to 10 day forecast looking a lot nicer. We'll talk about that, and we'll take a look at what we can expect in the way of rainfall. Better chances by later on this week, but just rain. Not looking at anything in the way of thunderstorms so far, so definitely some good news where that's concerned. Chilly tonight, heading out for a late dinner and a movie or wherever you're going. You're going to want to make certain to ward off that chill as temperatures by midnight afterwards in the metro area and the rest of the Mid-South will be dropping into the lower to mid-30s, maybe even around freezing for the metro area. Remember, again, tomorrow morning, if there's frost on your windshield, scrape the entire windshield clean, that whole periscope driving thing, just a little bit of the windshield cleaned off. Not a smart thing, very dangerous. So again, all the windows totally cleaned off if you have frost out there and looking at some pretty chilly conditions out there. Welcome to everybody who's checking in. William Skage, a little farther north in the Mid-South, 27 in Lower Michigan, 43 in Olive Branch, Melissa Ann Frost. Thank you very much for checking in from there. And everybody else from around the rest of the Mid-South. Pensacola, Deborah Lee Russell, a little bit warmer down that direction, I would hope anyway. 58 degrees currently for the Mid-South area, for the Memphis area, for a high temperature today. Relatively close, but just a little bit below normal for this time of the year. Low temperature this morning, 2 degrees below freezing, and that's way below where we should be. No precipitation to show up today. Almost 2 feet ahead on rainfall for the year. It's been a very wet 2019 across the Mid-South. From the Grove in Oxford, lots of people out and about for tonight's festivities before, during, and after the game tonight. And looking again at some dry conditions out there, but it's definitely brisk for the football in the Grove area, 37 degrees. Fortunately, winds in and around the area are close to the center part of the Ole Miss campus, looking very calm, and again, not showing any problems with wind chill, but it is still going to be chilly out there for tonight. Not seeing any problems with traffic, actually some very light traffic for a Saturday night, taking a look around the area of I-240 and Poplar, back toward Park Avenue and Quince around the overpasses there. No problems on the roadways for this evening. Just a little bit up farther on the roadway, I-40 and Witten Road looking good with clear skies across the area. More clouds drifting on through as we get into tomorrow, but we'll talk more about that in the forecast coming up in just a little bit. Our next storm system is getting organized and ready to go over the high plains and the Rockies. This is going to be heading our direction, but it's already got two strikes against it. Number one, it's heading into very dry air. Notice here with the satellite picture, there's hardly any clouds out there, so again, exceptionally dry across the Mid-South. Number two, this is a continental-based system. It's not coming in from off the oceans or off the Gulf, so this is moving across the land surface, bringing with it some moisture from off the Pacific, but not much. And as it goes a little bit closer to us, this is going to be about all the moisture it can tap into. So we're not looking at anything in the way of a lot of precipitation into and around the Mid-South area for the next couple of days. What about tonight? Well, again, the umbrella will not be necessary. Clean sweeps across the entire Mid-South on Storm Tracker 3S radar, so not seeing much out there for now. Paulette Morrow, 39 degrees in New Bern, Tennessee. Thank you very much for that weather report there, and everybody else tuning in from across the area and beyond. We're already back in the lower to mid-40s, and these on WeatherNet 3 are some of the warmest numbers that we've got across the area for right now. Again, just past about 8 o'clock on Saturday night. Lower to mid-40s, and winds on the light side, not exactly a wind chill, but again, winds will be diminishing as we go toward overnight, so that should help things out by just a little bit. It's dry in the area. It should remain that way overnight. Temperatures by News Channel 3 at 10, 30s and lower 40s. Into tomorrow morning, again, we've got a very dry atmosphere. Low temperatures tomorrow back in the lower to mid-30s for the lowest point of the day. Now, in a dry atmosphere like this, the computer models, they just get really overexcited to get the moisture back in here somehow. So it starts to put in these markers for rain or even snow if it's cold enough. But once again, tomorrow is just going to be so dry across the area that we're going to have cloud cover coming on through. We can safely ignore this in the way of precipitation because we're just not picking up much of anything out there in the way of moisture to give us any chance of rainfall, at least for Sunday. So we'll see the clouds increase, starting off hopefully clear into portions of overnight. More clouds into tomorrow morning. As we go into tomorrow afternoon, we'll see better chances of cloud cover out there. But once again, I just don't see anything in the way of rainfall really affecting us. Even if it does bring in some moisture several thousand feet up, as that rain drops down toward the surface, that's dry air between the rain and the surface. So it's probably going to evaporate for the most part on the way down. So chances of rain tomorrow, minimal at best, especially out west of us, and then moving our direction as we go into and around early Monday morning. That'll be our best chance of anything involving showers across much of the area for right now. Avery Nellum, Ripley, Mississippi, 40 degrees and clear, and an order for snow as well. Well, that order is going to have to wait for at least a while anyway. Sorry about that for right now. Welcome to everybody who's tuning in for this evening. Glad to have you along for the ride. Here's what it looks like across the Mid-South as we go into the next couple of days. Again, today's going to be looking a lot like tomorrow's going to be looking a lot like today, with temperatures back in the lower to mid-50s and increasing clouds throughout the rest of the day. There will be that chance of showers coming up as we get into and around very early on Monday, but we're just not seeing much of anything out there in the way of confidence that we're going to be getting anything more than a couple of raindrops. So temperatures back in the mid-50s on Monday. Behind that storm system coming on through, drier air, and that means clearer skies, and that means more sunshine, and that means your utility bill might be picking up a bit of a break. As we get some sunshine in here, you can open up the blinds and the drapes and get some free solar heating going on, so looking a little bit milder, closer to normal by about Tuesday. Just above normal for the next couple of days, Wednesday and Thursday, back in the mid to upper 60s, so it's going to be feeling very pleasant, even a little bit warmer than what autumn should be out there. But by Wednesday night into and around Friday, and unfortunately the weekend, that's where we see that potential of maybe some scattered showers coming our way. Now here's the thing at this point in time, so again, we're not going to be seeing anything in the way of frozen precipitation with this. It's going to be just too warm out there over the course of the next couple of days. So chances of rain, yes. Chances of snow or frozen precipitation, not seeing that. And added bonus, at this time of the year, we can get some very strong storm systems coming through that can create severe weather. That also is not showing any signs of happening, again, for right now. Now, does that mean it's going to stay that way throughout the rest of the autumn season into winter? Probably not, but at least for this forecast, we're just not really picking up much of anything out there in the way of problems. Rain sticks around through the first half of next weekend, leaves by Sunday morning. At least that's the way it looks like right now. That time frame could change over the next several days. So again, keep it tuned to the weather experts again for more information on that for right now. But beyond any chances of rainfall, not seeing it to be cool enough for anything involving frozen precip, and not seeing any thunderstorms either. So rain, yes, everything else pretty much gone and out of here for right now. As always, things will change, so the weather experts will keep you updated on that, so stay tuned for more over the course of the next several days and weeks. Couple of things going on with the tropics, well, at least one just outside of the tropics. We've got a storm system just off the coast of the Carolinas, And this thing is getting deeper in the atmosphere. It's strengthening as it gets a lot more low pressure and it gets lower isobars out there. The storm system gets stronger as the winds swirl around that thing, trying to fill up that gap in the atmosphere. So for right now, it's not tropical. It does not have a name by the National Hurricane Center, but it is going to be watched very carefully over the next couple of days. We could be looking at the possibility of a 2 to 4 feet, can't even get that on screen right there, of excess surge at high tide as the system comes on through the area. Now, we not only have that, but we have very strong winds taking place, gale force winds, roughly between about 30 to 60 miles per hour could be a possible problem. And the flow of this, again, air around low pressure in the northern hemisphere rotates counterclockwise. So this whole thing is going to be bringing in a ton of moisture off the ocean surface. Add to that, well back to the north, there's strong high pressure over Canada rotating the opposite direction. So that funneling effect is going to be bringing some very ugly weather to parts of the coastal Carolinas. So anything north of Florida, anything south of Chesapeake Bay, if you're heading that direction tomorrow, could be some possible major slowdowns out there because of the system going on, eventually making its way up the East Coast. Not a threat to the Memphis and Mid-South area. So why are we telling you about this? Well, because we are the station that is on your side, and we want to make certain that you know more about travel difficulties, and this could be a major headache if you're heading toward the Carolina coast into tomorrow and anything south of D.C. or Baltimore. So again, please keep that in mind as you head on out into that area. Now, down to areas close to the Baja Peninsula on the opposite side of the continent, western Mexico, tropical storm Raymond, winds of 45 miles per hour. It's going to be slowly making its way up the west coast of Mexico, but this could also do a pretty good job of bringing some moisture to where it is most desperately needed. Now, whether or not this curves back our direction and affects us, a little bit too early to tell on that, but hopefully this will start to bring in Pacific moisture, maybe helping the firefighting efforts in Southern California. That's the way it looks like for right now, if it continues on this path. But once again, that could also change. So we'll be watching that very carefully as we go throughout the rest of the weekend. So if you're planning on heading to Southern California, you got fires, you got smoke, you might have some problems down around Phoenix or Tucson with some lower visibility and maybe some early monsoon conditions out there. At least that's a possible problem. We'll keep our eyes on that for you as well. James R. Gulledge from Humboldt, Tennessee, a double shot tonight from the full moon just a few days ago. Beautiful view from around Humboldt, Tennessee. Thank you for that one. From Raising Girls in the 38002 zip code, getting some winter-type precipitation earlier this week, covering part of the cars and the windshields up there. Thank you for that one. From DEANC 586, not too sure how to pronounce that one, but taking a look at some of the cloud cover out there, the Hernando de Soto Bridge from the Auction Street Bridge, looking back towards sunset earlier this week, looking at some alto cumulus clouds and lined up in those kind of cloud streets, as they're called, again, with kind of gaps in between some of those all the way out to the horizon. So thank you very much for that one. And James R. Gulledge, comparison shot from 1 year beforehand as the winter weather moved through earlier this last week, taking a look at what happened back in 2018 in Humboldt, Tennessee. So a nice little historical comparison there when it came to some of the precip that moved on through parts of Humboldt almost 1 year to the date afterwards. So kind of nice to be able to see that. Got weather pictures? We'd love to show them and put them on News Channel 3 social media for everybody to see them, but we can't show them if you don't send them. So again, please send them in to us, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, link through on there, or if you want to just email me, again, easy way to do that, austen.onek@wreg.com, and we'll be glad to help you out on that. Plus, check out the podcast, Tornado Alert Emotional Terror, where Tim and Jim will tell you more about what it's like to be on the air during severe weather, knowing that your loved ones might be affected by severe weather. What do we do here at News Channel 3? What do our colleagues do at various other sister stations around the United States? Very fascinating look at what goes on. And again, Tornado Alert Emotional Terror, available for download at iTunes, Spotify, and you can pick it up at the weather page at WREG.com if you'd like to be able to see a little bit more about that. All right, rest of the evening, overnight, wrapping things up with temperatures right around freezing by dawn patrol tomorrow morning, back in the lower to mid-30s. And also seeing, again, numbers rising pretty nicely, but it's going to be a chilly day coming up again tomorrow, about like today, with numbers back in the lower to mid-50s with increasing clouds as we go throughout the rest of the day tomorrow. Not seeing any rainfall chances, but again, Monday morning could be some very slim potential out there, and that's going to be about as much as we look at for there. So not seeing too much in the way of major problems, and that chance of rain later on this week, that could also change one way or another. We'll keep you updated on that as we go throughout the rest of the forecast. That'll wrap it up for tonight's edition of News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, coming up on my Facebook page at about a quarter till 9 tonight. We'll take a quick look at what's going on at weather, where the troops are. If you have friends or loved ones in the United States military, we'll take a look at some of the locations around the world where those who are wearing the uniform of our country are serving. So stay tuned for more on that. I'll have more on News Channel 3 at 10, as well as on News Channel 3 Daybreak coming up bright and early tomorrow morning. Again, as always, questions, concerns, comments, suggestions about what you'd like to see on here, drop me a line at austen.onek@wreg.com, and would love to hear from you on that. Stay tuned for more with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the weekend. Thanks for joining us for News Channel 3's exclusive video weather blog, Weather Overtime, for Saturday night.